What up, though? And welcome back to Old School Hip Hop Head Rio Reacts. I also have another YouTube channel called Rio's Reactions, and on that YouTube channel, it's 99% old school golden era hip hop. So if you're ever in the mood to watch some old school hip hop reactions, all you have to do is go to the link that I'm going to put in the description of this video. Alright, man, so before I go any further, let me say, welcome back to Rio's on Sundays, baby. So today we have a subscriber request. Shout out to the boy Norris for this request. This is Ronnie Foster, Mystic Brew, live at Jazz is Dead. I don't know if I picked this live version or if he picked this live version. So Norris, if you see this, let me know if you picked this or if this is just some shit I just ran with, because I love live archival footage. Alright, man. Yo, so I've never heard of Ronnie Foster. I've never heard of Mystic Brew. And I've never heard of Jazz is Dead. So, and I don't even listen to jazz. So this is going to be an adventure. Alright, let's get it. Oh my God. Every hip hop head in the world should know what this is, yo. Everybody. I ain't gonna even say the goddamn name, because I feel like older people watch my Soul on Sundays joint. So let me introduce y'all to what A Tribe Called Quest did with this song. Alright? I'll be right back. Alright, man, I got the Tribe video queued up, but I'm just gonna play a couple seconds of this Ronnie Foster joint so I can hear how much of the sample that Tribe actually used, and so you guys could get a fresh ear for the song. And then when I bring up the Tribe thing, you can see the similarity or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Alright, so let's listen to a little bit more of this Ronnie Foster. Ronnie Foster, you a bad motherfucker, Ronnie Foster. Oh, shit. All right. Whoa. Yo, I got goosebumps. I don't think Tribe changed shit about this beat. All right, man, let's get to that Tribe joint. Let's get to that Tribe. 1993. Let's get it.
Hey, yo, my man Fife Diggy, he got something to say.
I like him brown, yellow, Puerto Rican, or Haitian. Name is Fife Dog from the Zulu Nation. Told you in the jam that we could get down. Now let's knock the boots like the group H-Town.
So, alright, man, yo. There it is, yo. That's what hip hop does, man. I say it and I'll keep saying it. Hip hop was important because it kept the previous generation's genres of music alive, yo. Like, I would have never known about or heard this song before if it wasn't for A Tribe Called Quest. It's like what Stessa Sonic said about James Brown way back in the day on Talking All That Jazz. That was like their first number one hit or whatever you want to call it. And a dude said, to tell you the truth, James Brown was old until Eric and Rock came out with I Got Soul. You know what I'm saying? And we talking 1986, 1987. You know what I'm saying? So salute to hip hop for keeping previous generations' genres of music alive. All right? And yo, everybody take a moment to say RIP and salute to the boy Fife Dog, as you see right here on our screen. He's a member of a Tribe Called Quest. He was the other MC in the group along with Q-Tip and Ali Shaheed Muhammad and Jerobi White. But anyway, Fife died. He had a kidney disease his whole life. So he passed away. You know, it's been some time now. I would say like 5-6 years ago. So, yo, salute RIP to the guy, Fife Dog. And now let's get back to Mystic River. To this motherfucking drummer, yo. God damn. The drummer and the bass line. Ooh, this shit is heavy.
To experience
the
masters early. I was 12 at the time, and I used to go to this jazz club in my hometown.
Man, I was not expecting this, son. I was not expecting this. This is kind of dope. Yo, I ain't gonna front. I was vibing the fuck out to this song, son. I can play this shit right now in my goddamn car. I ain't lying. I can knock this. This is a banger, my nigga. Holy shit, Norris. Holy shit. Norris, goddamn it, Norris. Salute to Norris. Yo, shout out Norris for this shit right here. One of my top five favorite hip-hop songs of all time. And their original version is basically identical, and this shit is fire. You know what I'm saying? All right, OG. Oh, my nigga Ronnie Foster about to give us the knowledge right now.
I got to experience a lot of the masters early. I was 12 at the time. And I used to go to this jazz club in my hometown, Buffalo. And the owner...
Shout out Griselda.
You know, fortunately for me, would let me sneak in.
Okay.
Jimmy was coming into town, and I had never met Jimmy, but obviously. A huge fan. So I asked the owner, I said, oh, where's Jimmy staying? He said, oh, some hotel on Main Street. In
Jimmy who? Hendrix?
I called, Jimmy Smith's room, please.
Jimmy Smith.
Hello, Jimmy Smith's voice. I said, Mr. Smith, this is Ronnie Foster. I'm a little young organ player around in town. You got to show me something. He said, boy, when you hear me play, you won't want to play anymore. He wanted to know how hungry I was. He wasn't just giving it up, you know. So next day, we met at the club, and that started our relationship.
Wow. Wait a second. So did this nigga start become a professional musician at the age of 12? Did I just hear that correctly? Damn. This boy Ronnie Foster's a bad motherfucker. Yo, I wish they weren't talking over the goddamn fucking organ playing that he doing right now. So he going in. But it's like in the background, yo. I'm going to have to do the studio version after this. But anyway, let's keep it moving.
Our relationship. George Benson was a huge fan of Jimmy. And so George came
in. Listen to him back there. Yo, listen to him in the background say, you're crazy.
Was a huge fan of Jimmy. And so George came in early to catch Jimmy's last set. Jimmy goes, George, meet little young organ player Ronnie Foster. And I started playing with George on weekends when I was 15, still in school, you know. And then you go on to Breezin' and all that stuff. And that introduction changed my whole musical path. Every style of music. It's a chameleon. It can be anything. All music is valid. If you don't like it, that's okay. But whatever music is what that person is feeling. You know, so it's valid because it comes from somewhere.
Is it over? Oh! Wow. Great. That was great. I did not expect that. Aye, man, yo, that was fire. Yo, that was dope. I guess I like jazz music, son. You know, because if you think about it, probably most of the hip-hop samples from back in the day came from jazz music. I ain't fucking know. You know what I'm saying? Holy shit, son. Ronnie Foster, you's a bad motherfucker, Ronnie Foster. Yo, I'm about to see if I can find a studio version of this joint. Alright? If not, on to the next one. I'm out. But if so, stay tuned.